And now for a presentation from the Gambles Game Room. The Sky Slide was made in Madison Gamble's basement, as you can see, from old pool tubing, duct tape, and strings that hang from the ceiling.
Hi, I'm Madison Gamble, the creator of the Sky Slide. I'm here to give a few pointers relating to the physics behind the coaster. The ball wouldn't stay rolling along the bottom of the tube without gravity. When the ball sits at the starting hill, it is in a state of inertia until gravity pulls it down through the coaster. The hills and loops needed to be at just the right tilt so that gravity could be used to keep the ball moving.
And this is my sister Johanna, who will be putting the ball through the roller coaster today. The ball that was used for the car of the roller coaster was from magnetics. It has a larger mass that allows it to move through the roller coaster more effectively than, say, a bouncy ball or a ball with a smaller mass.
With this type of roller coaster, you can actually hear the friction as the ball makes its way down the tube. This is an example of rolling friction.
As the ball goes through the loop, it is pulled in a circle because of some centripetal force. This inwards force allows all things to move in a circle, such as the planets in orbit.
This ball has a larger mass, so it will accelerate faster, causing a higher velocity. This produces more momentum. The total momentum will stay the same until the slope of the tubing changes. This is because velocity will change when acceleration changes due to gravitational force. Velocity times mass equals momentum. The two factors of potential energy are the shape and position of the ball. At the beginning of the coaster, when we hold the ball at the top, there is potential energy. We can assume that when we let go, the ball will move through the tubes because of gravity. As the ball goes down hill one of 2.5 feet, it will accelerate. As it goes through loop one, it will start to decelerate. As it goes down hill two of 4 feet, it will accelerate until it comes to loop two, where it will decelerate. Then going down hill three of 1.5 feet to accelerate, and then decelerate to come to the end. The ball has kinetic energy as it moves. When it accelerates, kinetic energy increases. When the ball comes to a stop, potential energy once again is stored. The ball is in a resting position until an outside force, gravity, sets the ball in motion. This is an example of Newton's first law. The object in this case, the ball, would not move until an external force caused it to. Once the ball continues through the coaster, an outside force, which would be the friction of the ground, will stop it. This is the case when the object will continue moving until an outside force is applied. If we wanted the ball to increase its acceleration, we would have to apply more force to it than, say, a rubber ball. This is because objects of more mass have less acceleration. More force is required to accelerate them. This force could be increased by making steeper slopes and tighter loops on the coaster. You could also decrease the mass of the ball. Then there would be more acceleration in the coaster as it is now. The third law states that for every action force, there is an equal and opposite reaction. All forces come in pairs. So when the ball travels down the ball pushes the tube, and the tube pushes back. This allows the ball to roll and stay in the tube.
As you can see, making this loop be supported with the rope hanging from the ceiling was very difficult. I had to make sure the ropes were in just the right place on the loop so that the tilt would be perfect so that gravity could bring the ball to the end. When suspending the roller coaster from the ceiling, we realized that the connectors of the tubes caused the ball to slow down. So the slope of each hill had to be just right so that the ball would continue over the connectors without stopping. As time went on, the strings started to loosen, and the original loop 2 that I had made didn't work. So we ended up having to redo loop 2, and now it is more efficient than it was before. Thank you for coming to the Gamble's Game Room. Please join us next time for another presentation by Madison Gamble.